Good afternoon, students and parents. My name is John Krajeski, Assistant Transformational Leader with Toledo Public Schools. Today, we're at Woodward High School. As safety is our number one concern at Toledo Public Schools, we're here today to provide you a snapshot of what you and your students will see as they return to school on March 1st.
Hello, I am Dr. Chelle Pelz, and I am the Senior Director of Pupil Placement for Toledo Public Schools. I'm going to share with you a few things that you need to know so that you are better prepared when you come back to school for in-person instruction. We will not be serving breakfast in the cafeterias at our high schools this year. There is food pickup on Wednesdays for all of our students to have breakfast at home. Because we won't be serving breakfast, there is no need for students to arrive early. They should be arriving on time. And students, when you do arrive, you are to enter the building at the designated door, go straight to your locker. We are asking that students not share lockers with other students for their own safety, and then go directly to your first class. Something that you're going to notice is different when you come back is that we are going to be assigning different colored lanyards to our students. Students that are following the A schedule will be given a clear plastic lanyard with red on it. Students that are following the B schedule will be given a clear plastic lanyard with blue on it. And those students that are following the C schedule will be given an actual clear lanyard with no color on it. These lanyards are for students to put their student IDs in. If you do not have a student ID, an ID will be provided to you within the first few weeks of school. In the meantime, until you do get that ID, you will still be asked to wear the appropriate lanyard for the day and schedule that you follow. In preparation for learning in an in-person environment, we are asking that all of our students come with a fully charged Chromebook on their assigned days. Also, remember to bring all of your supplies with you so that you are prepared and ready to learn. If students are coming to school prepared, they'll be set up better for a successful school year.
Hello, my name is Scott Biggs and I'm an assistant principal at White High School. I'm here today to talk to you about several ways to reduce exposure. We should be following social distancing protocols in our school buildings, so you should remain 6 feet apart from one another in the hallways, classrooms, and other common areas. Follow signs to stay to the right in hallways and stairwells. Sanitizing stations will be provided throughout the building and hallways and other areas. Also, cleaning supplies will be provided in each classroom. Upon your return to the building, please bring a water bottle to fill up at the water fountain. That will be the only way you will be permitted to use the water fountains. We hope if you follow these guidelines, we can reduce exposure and have a healthy year back at school.
Hi, I'm Paulette Cole. I'm the assistant principal at Toledo Early College High School. And today, I'm just giving you a reminder that when you come into the buildings, you will have to wear an appropriate mask. An appropriate mask is one that covers your nose and your mouth completely. Please bring extra masks with you just in case you need one throughout the day. While you're in the cafeteria seated and eating, that will be the only time you'll be allowed to have your masks off. While in the cafeteria, you will notice that there's designated seating.
My name is Megan Barnum. I'm the Dean of Students at Bowser High School. Be sure to wash your hands throughout the day. If you are unable to wash your hands, you can also use sanitizer that's provided in the hallways, and you are welcome to bring your own sanitizer. If you are experiencing any of the following symptoms listed on screen, please remember to stay home and have a parent or guardian call the school to let them know so that you may receive an excused absence. If a student becomes symptomatic throughout the school day, the school nurse will call home and the child will be sent home. We hope that by following the steps in this video, you will have a healthy and successful TPS proud year.